This video is inspired by numerous comments I've seen over the years regarding the mystery of what lies beneath Union Street. Descriptions such as: a network of hidden vaults.
Vaulted caverns which shoulder the carriageway above.
Secret access, strange artifacts and of old cottages and the like existing below the vaulted stonework of Aberdeen's viaducts are only some that I've seen through the years. The subject always seems to bring out fantastic half-remembered retellings of second-hand stories and conversation and the always colourful comment sections of social media. I always wanted to try to answer the mystery that seems to exist about this. So, what lies under Union Street?
Well, reality is sadly less interesting than the speculation. This part here is all built in plain fields, so there's really not much of interest here at all. This part is a bridge. This part here was built in mysterious vaults. And this part over here is almost certainly very close to the original geography. And we know that because we have Parson Gordon's plan of Aberdeen showing it in 1661. Now that shows the toll booth, which was built in 1616, and there's been no clear changes to the elevation in the area since. So, there we have it. Thanks for watching. You want to know more about the mysterious vaults, don't you? Okay, fine, but get your coat. It's nae warm outside.
We're getting close to winter right now at the time of recording, and the skies are almost permanently grey. Which means two things in the context of this video. One is I'm going to moan about the weather, and two is you won't be seeing any bonny scenes like I captured for my video about Aberdeen's ancient road in the summer this time. The photography in this video is going to look a bit drab in comparison, unfortunately. Yes. A dull shadow now looms over the Silver City.
I was still talking about the weather, but yeah, I guess this image fits. Anyway, let's take a look at Union Street.
In the 18th century, Aberdeen's medieval streets dodged around a vertically diverse landscape. It was described as crooked, narrow, tortuous and hilly, which made the development of a modern city centre challenging. The town's council wanted to expand to the flat plains in the west, but the Denburn Valley stood in the way. A surveyor from Glasgow, Charles Abercrombie's vision, was the grand street we know today as Union Street. King Street was also a part of Abercrombie's plan, but it's not as nice, so we don't talk about it much. Due to the year it was constructed, Union Street is named after the Acts of Union 1800. That's the one where Ireland joined the Kingdom of Great Britain, forming the United Kingdom of Great Britain. Not the Acts of Union 1706, which marked the Kingdom of England and the Kingdom of Scotland uniting to form Great Britain, after Scotland lost great swathes of its wealth trying to establish a colony in Panama. And also not the Union of Crowns 1603, where James VI of Scotland also became monarch of England and Ireland. And also not the Trade Union Act of 1871, which set the groundwork for labour. The unified field theory equally is not. Here we have the area of most interest to the discussion at hand, between the Castlegate and Union Bridge. A lot of work went into levelling off this area. I'll mark the line of where Union Street is today so you have some context. St Catherine's Hill had its top chopped off, so I'll mark this area, which centres on roughly where the Adelphi is now, in red, as this was all lowered. The green line shows the length of the street that had to be raised. The streets of Backwind, Correction Wind, and Ship Row would never be the same again. All cut short or built over, and the slum of Patachi Side on the west side of St. Catherine's Hill would be swept away entirely. I'll now mark the areas where existing buildings have raised the landscape to where it is today. These obviously have basements and foundations keeping them held up, but what about Union Street itself? This old painting of Union Bridge's construction probably gives us the best idea of how the vaults under Union Street were designed. The bridge itself is the centre span. It remains to this day the largest single-span granite bridge in the world. The viaduct which has been built to the right is what supports Union Street at this end. Today, this is where you'd cross the road to get from Jameson and Carrie to Primark. The unconquered plains which would facilitate the expansion of Aberdeen lie to the left. Let's start at the east side of Union Street and see what traces we can find of the arches. From the Broad Street junction here, heading toward the Castle Gate, we can be reasonably sure that we're close to the original geography here, as I illustrated earlier in the video. The lane at the right-hand side of this image marks Ship Row, which skirted the base of St. Catherine's Hill. So, we can be reasonably sure that this next section has been largely flattened and are unlikely to find vaults here. We shortly pass the entrance to the Adelphi, where the hill would have peaked. It's hard to imagine all this was flattened. Adelphi Lane to the right retains a downward slope, but even this would be much shallower than the original geography, as it terminates on Market Street rather than Old Patachi Side, which would have been much lower. As we reach Market Street, we are now squarely standing on the top of a man-made hill. Let's go and take a look and see what lies underneath. Carnegie's Brae can be accessed from the Nether Kirkgate. It was here that Benham's Lodge, more commonly known as the Wallace Tower, stood. As it was built in the 1600s, we can use old photos of it to see that the route to its left, sloping downwards towards Patachi Side, is somewhat more or less the path of Carnegie's Brae today. The Nether Kirkgate, on the other hand, would have driven through Markies, leading uphill toward the Mither Kirk. That leads me to be quite confident that, sans St. Nicholas Square above, we have a similar geography here to the original. We continue under the street. As we enter the tunnel below, we get an idea of what lies hidden beneath some of Aberdeen's streets. The arches to the right follow the line of St. Nicholas Street, which once connected George Street and Union Street before the St. Nicholas Centre was built. The reinforced concrete roof above us here is a newer addition. Note in this old photo of St. Nicholas Street, the area behind the fencing next to Clydesdale Bank on the right drops down below street level where we are now standing. While we're here, I'll mention that the statue of Queen Victoria far right currently resides in the middle of Queen's Cross Roundabout, where it faces west towards Balmoral. The arch in front of us is supporting Union Street. Taking a look to the adjacent Unit 51 nightclub at the east side, we see a similar construction, and likewise, taking a look into the Tunnels nightclub at the other side, we can see that this construction pattern continues under the road as we travel west. Although, out back of the nightclub, we see much narrower arches support the buildings on the south side of Union Street above. Specifically, we are looking at the bottom of the Cafe Nero building. As we continue west, we soon find a gap in the buildings which will let us go down and take a look to see what's underneath the street here. Taking the stairs beside the graveyard, we see it's not too dissimilar from the tunnels we found earlier. The southern side of the arch reveals the road underneath is at an incline sloping away from the Mither Kirk towards the sea, as it's noticeably taller than the north side. We're going to stay down here and take a few steps back. We find ourselves at the green, which we can be relatively sure is probably the original geography of the area for the same reasons as the Castle Gate. We can clearly see here that Union Street is 2 to 3 stories above the original ground level. This crude drawing, very crude, will hopefully help illustrate what is probably supporting the road behind the buildings. We can take a look behind the steps leading back up to Union Street here, in the hopes of seeing one last arch before we arrive at the bridge. Sadly, however, there's not much that can be seen due to the more recent 1930s construction of these stairs. Although, taking a look at the older set of stairs doesn't actually reveal anything more interesting. We've now arrived at Union Bridge. The metal braces were a 1908 addition, which now support the pavement at the north side of the bridge. There used to be a set at the south side of the bridge too, but we'll cover that in a minute. In the original plans, the bridge was to be a three-arch design, but engineer Thomas Fletcher found flaws in it after the foundations were constructed. As a result, it was scrapped, and the contract for its construction reallocated to Fletcher, who is responsible for the bridge we have today. As we venture under the tunnel, we find its underside less attractive than the fine-dressed granite that's adorned its side. We find ourselves directly under the pavement at the south side of Union Bridge now. A metal structure on stilts holds up the frontage to the Trinity Centre to our left. This frontage marks the location of the Shargar Shoppes. These shops were built on the south side of Union Bridge in the 1960s, blocking the view to the south amongst popular protest. The Trinity Centre was further built on the back of them in the 1980s. The Trinity Centre is now overhead. It's a fascinating, if somewhat eerie, somewhat grim area of town to explore. If stalactites and pigeon droppings aren't your thing, well, maybe best give this one a miss. It's funny to compare this to the picturesque scene in this 1807 sketch by John Carr. Before the metal braces, before the Shargar Shoppes, before the Trinity Centre, before the Denburn was buried. On the other side of Union Bridge, we come to the last of the vaults. And the best image I can find of them is this one, taken sometime after the fire and subsequent demolition of the Palace Hotel, where Travelodge is now. You can actually just barely see the outline of the arches of the viaduct at this side of the bridge behind the brick facade. The brick facade hides the part of the viaduct which has just started to be built in this image. This is all you'll see of it today. The lower levels of the Travel Lodge are on the left, and the entrance to the Trinity Centre car park is on our right. Once again, we find ourselves under Bridge Street. You'll remember from my other video that this is the original route into Aberdeen, so likely illustrates the original geography of the area again. Windmill Brae, which is the backside of this stretch of Union Street, marks the last part of Union Street you're likely to find any vaults. As we turn to face south, we reach the flat plains that Aberdeen's 19th century council were so eager to reach. Taking a look behind this stretch of Union Street reveals streets almost equally as flat. So, is that it? Is there nothing of interest under the streets here? Well, not under Union Street. The cable subway does run under here on Langstane Place. This is a Victorian-era access tunnel designed to facilitate distribution of DC power from Aberdeen's own power plant on Milburn Street. But it had to be dug out, showing that we are indeed standing on soil, not viaduct here. Here's what the tunnel looks like, if you are curious. And here's what the air vent for the tunnel looks like. If you've ever wondered about this thing just off Holborn Street, now you know what it is. But what about those scary looking vaults in the video thumbnail? Okay, they're technically not under Union Street. They are part of the vaulting that leads from Union Street down Market Street. Here's the original photo. You can just make out the sign for the tunnel's nightclub in the distance. And here's what the entrance looks like. This space is currently being used to lease car parking spaces. It'd be located here, under Market Street, in front of the market. As a footnote, since we're back at Market Street, in this image of Ship Row, which illustrates the base of St. Catherine's Hill, we can see old Dr. Drake's place. Younger viewers may remember this as Malone's Late Bar, and older viewers may remember this as Sir Laugh-A-Lot's. While I was researching this video, I found that the frontage to this building is actually part of a 14th century wall, according to Arkams. This wall may have stood here the same time as the Ottoman Empire was founded, or may have seen the Black Death. Robert the Bruce may even have walked past it. That's pretty old. Well, I hope you enjoyed this look under Union Street. I guess that unless you want to know about the mysterious tunnels underneath the tunnels under Union Street, that's the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Now, from a certain point of view, there are actually tunnels that run underneath the viaduct we explored in this video. The Den Burn, which runs under Union Street, was buried and enclosed in a culvert, and that last photo is actually part of an Urbex report exploring those tunnels. It's a fascinating read, and I've left a link in the video description if you'd like to see more.